Two little girls walk up to a boy in a wheelchair and throw something at him. They then laugh at them and say that he was the way he was supposed to be. At that moment, the little boy's mother arrives and sends them away. She then apologizes to her son for being distracted and what happened and cleans him up. She then says that those girls were very mean. A little girl sees it in the distance and tells her mother that it was wrong. The mother says that unfortunately there are bad people in the world and the mothers of these children did not teach them that. The little boy's mother tells her son that they should go home and so they leave. The little girl says she didn't like it and then the mother says she wasn't supposed to be like that. She then says that she wants to leave and her mother asks why she wants to leave, because she was asking a lot to go there. The little girl then says that she didn't like to see that kind of thing and leaves. Some time later, the little girl spots the boy and asks her mother to go talk to him. Her mother then asks if her daughter wanted to go talk to the little boy and she says yes. She then greets the boy's mother and asks her name. The woman then says their names to the little girl and she says their names were very beautiful. The little girl then says that she saw them earlier in the square and asks if she could play with the boy as she wanted to be friends with the little boy. The woman then thanks the little girl and says that her son would not be able to play like other children, as her son can only move his head. The little girl then says that she doesn't care and that she wants to be friends with the boy if the woman lets her. The woman then says that that was a very nice action of hers and asks if she really wanted to be friends with her son, as her son hadn't had a friend for a long time. The little girl then says that she was going to be his best friend and that she was going to take really good care of him. The woman then says that they couldn't play that day, as it was time for the little boy to take his medicine. She then says that if the little girl wanted, she could come over to her house the next day to play with her son. The little girl then asks her mother if she could go to the woman's house and her mother says yes and would take her there. The next day, the little girl's mother tells her daughter that that was the little boy's house. She then agrees and asks her mother to ring the house bell. The mother then rings the bell and then the woman opens her door and the little girl says that she was there to play with the boy. The woman then tells them to go to a square she had close by, as she wanted her son to stay in touch with nature. The little girl agrees with that and then they go to the square together. When they get there, the woman then says that the little girl could play with her son while she and the little girl's mother would talk nearby. The little girl then tells the woman that she would take good care of the little boy. She then says that she had taken those papers so they can draw. She says she knew the little boy couldn't draw, but she could ask her and she would draw for him. He then tells her to draw a dog and she says that she was also very fond of dogs. She then adjusts the little boy's chair so he can see her drawing. She then starts to draw. Soon she finishes and says that his drawing was ready. He says it turned out really nice and she is happy that he liked the drawing. She then says that the two would play hide and seek. She then says that he needed to find her. He soon finds where she was and says he found her. He then smiles and the two continue joking. They play together for a while and then the little girl says she wanted to rock a little. She says that she knew he couldn't do that one, but that one day they could swing together. She then goes to the toy and meanwhile, the little boy watched her with a smile on his face. The little girl then says they were going to walk around the park and then starts pushing the little boy's wheelchair. The little girl then takes the boy for a walk and then tells him that she was very fond of him. She says she had that he could walk again one day and the little boy says he believed that too. She then says that it was getting late and that they should go to their mothers. She then helps the little boy with the chair and then goes to them. The little girl then tells her mother that it's about time they left. She agrees and then the woman asks if they had fun playing together. She says yes, and the little boy agrees with her. Some time later, the woman was telling the little girl that her son would not be able to play that day. She says her son was too weak for that. The little girl's mother then agrees and says he needed to rest. The little girl then says that everything was fine and asks if she could get the little boy a present. The woman then says yes and that her son would really appreciate it. She then hands a stuffed dog to the little boy and then the woman thanks the little girl. The little girl says that she hoped the little boy would keep that gift with him forever. Some time later, the woman was asking God to save her son, as he was everything in her life. She asks God not to take her son away from her and that she loved him very much. She then stays by her son's side as much time as she is allowed. The little boy opens his eyes and calls for his mother. The woman is very happy to hear her son's voice. He then tells his mother that she was very hungry. She then asks what her son wanted to eat and then he says he really needed to see the little girl because he missed her. She then says that soon they would see the little girl and then calls for the doctor and says that she has improved. The doctor soon appears and asks what had happened. The woman says that her son was doing better and that he was able to move his hands. The doctor is then surprised and says that it was a miracle, because all their exams said that he would not get better and that she was losing hope. The woman then says that she was grateful for everything the doctors did for her son and that she wanted to know when she could take him back home. The doctor says she needed to do some more tests to see if the little boy's health was good. She says if everything goes right, they could get out of that hospital quickly. The woman is very happy and says that they would wait for the results and that she was really looking forward to it. Some time later, the little girl tells her mother that she missed the little boy very much. The mother says that she missed him too and that she was praying a lot for the little boy to get better. She then says she would call the woman to see how the little boy was doing. The little girl then says that that square was never the same without the little boy, but at that moment the woman appears with her son. The two then are very happy to see them and the woman says that he missed the little girl a lot. The little girl then goes to him and hugs him. The little boy then greets the little girl, which makes her very surprised as the little boy was talking. He then says that he could also move his arms and shows her. This makes the little girl very happy and she says that there was warning to the little boy that one day he would walk again. The woman then says that she thought she was going to lose her son, but that God helped her and that now her son was on the mend. The mother then says that she was very happy about it and says that she had prayed a lot for the little boy's recovery. The woman says that she came to think that she would lose her child, but the mother says that God would not abandon them. The little girl then tells them to go play, as she has missed the little boy so much. The woman is happy to see the two playing together. The children then start playing around the park together, and they have a great time together.